I have a little thing here. Does this look like a real solid object to you? It's not an illusion, is it?
Looks like a knife.
It's a little knife. It's a pocket knife, is it not, Gabrielle?
It is.
It's like a pen knife, right?
Yeah.
Do you know why it's called a pen knife?
Because
it's as small as a pen. It's as small as a pen, no, but that was a good guess. In the old days, they used to make pens out of feathers. So they had to have a little knife like this that carved the end of the feather and make a quill pen. They called those pen knives. Thomas Jefferson, our president, invented the first folding pen knife just such as this one. So you see, the act is educational as well as entertaining. Now, when that knife disappears and comes out over here in my pocket, you know what most people will say?
What do they say?
They'll say, that wasn't magic at all. They say, that was just sleight of hand. Obviously, the knife went up this sleeve, came down this sleeve, and ended up in your pocket. And that's exactly what happened. On the other hand, if I showed you the knife and you held my wrist, hold my wrist, Elliot. Can you see the knife there? Mm-hmm. If you held my wrist and you did use your other hand so it doesn't block, everybody can see that. If you don't move your hand, you don't let go, and you don't take your eyes off my hand, Elliot, and I open my hand, that knife is gone. That would not be sleight of hand, would it? That would be real magic, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would.
That would be real magic.
Or trickery.
Folks, if I show you the knife and I close my hand and I open it up, that knife is gone. That would be real magic, would it not?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
No one can do that. Well, think about it. Think about it. The only way that can happen is if the magician first creates what we call the intricate web of distraction. Don't pay any attention. This is just to distract you. Well, it's stupid. See, it looks silly. It looks like the knife is changing colors from like black.
What the fuck?
Well, I got two knives. See, no. That's the whole thing. I have a little black knife. I have a little white knife. It's just trickery. This is just to distract you. I'm just playing with you. I got a little black knife and a little white knife. And what happens is I have one knife hidden in what we call the palming position. This is the palming position. From this side, you can see it, but look, from this side, you can't. This is a principle of magic. As long as I hold this hand in a perfectly natural fashion, no one's ever going to suspect it has a knife hidden on the other side. When the black knife comes over near the white knife, that's when I switch. Then I switch back. It's the secret to the whole thing. Now that you know how it's done, we'll do it in slow motion. I'll put the black knife over here in this hand. White knife is in this hand. Elliot, which knife is in this hand?
The white knife.
No, that's the switch, Elliot. Switch. Which knife is in this hand?
Black knife.
No, the white knife. Maybe it's confusing you having both knives out. I'll put one knife up. Just using the white knife. Hold my wrist really tight. Hold the wrist. We'll get the black knife out over here. And they never come anywhere near each other. Hold my wrist really tight. Which knife is in this hand?
The black knife.
Which knife is in this hand?
White knife.
Guess again?
White knife.
Yeah.
Black knife?
Great guess, but remember what I said about the intricate web of distraction?
Yes.
You've been distracted. Guess which knife is in my pocket? The white one. The black one's over here. It throws me off too. I don't follow this stuff. You guys have been a wonderful audience. Thank you very much. I'm Pop Haydn. Have a good night.